Okay, so my first question would be, what role does networking play in your career?
Well, we live in a relationship-based economy these days, so trust-based transitions, right? So networking is important, but it's very important to develop, the trust and ability and kind of give a potential customer, potential lead or potential anyone ability to trust you and refer you or re-refer you. Give you leads for potential business transactions. So yeah, as a answer, as network is important, but has to be based, has to have a core, a reason. You don't want just network, for nothing, right? So for business purposes, that's what it takes.
Absolutely. The next question is, what qualities do you look for when you hire a person in your career field?
Well, to circle back, I have three vested interests in life, right? I have a vested interest in education. I have vested interest in medical field. Senior care, home care, medical care, for seniors and stuff. And also trading, like wholesale.
I'm sorry, guys.
Wholesale, right? Wholesale from B2B wholesale, right? So all these areas has a quite different needs for hiring people. But for me to summarize and put everything kind of short in short stuff, for me it's very important the people's values, And again, to circle back on your question, if I know and somehow I know that people has a good values, and we have similar values in the business and we have a long term goals and that's a good start for me to get engaged in conversation and discussion about getting these persons on board, Because everything else is learnable and everything else is teachable. As long as people are willing to do that, and as long as people actually have a good values and we have our values and our values in my corporations and our corporations are match, So that's an answer for you.
On to the next one. What are the most rewarding aspects of your job?
Well, you're a student, right? So they probably taught you the pyramid of Maslow's hierarchy of needs, right? I don't know if you know that. So every individual has these needs, physical needs, emotional needs, financial needs, security needs, right? So the higher you go, actually needs are, you have more needs and you have more horizons. But for me, I actually would like, once you recognize as a professional, once you actually have some kind of financial security, once you actually have some kind of maturity, right, and have a family and you want to set an example, for me, for my values, it's extremely important whether it's a customer or friend or colleague or whatever, extend my services, extend my offerings, extend my stuff to really make impact on their lives. So that's a key. That's a key why I'm doing that. And it's very rewarding for me. It's nothing better for me. Nothing's better that feels that somebody will come back to me. I really appreciate what you've done for me. Thank you. That's a big deal. So whether it's a customer, or whether it's a friend, or whether it's something, it's big, So it's it's massive.
Okay, it's kind of a more depthy question, but how does the business side of the MBA compare or relate to the business aspects of the entrepreneurial profession?
I had privilege to work in the National Basketball Association at the bid. I was helping CBA, like a Chinese organizations, and I was working on the corporate side a little bit. It was 10 years ago, right after my retirement, some part-time jobs. And I don't know if you know, but I have my first degree. It's from sports business finance from New York University, right? So right across the street from the Olympic Tower. So I'm familiar with the MBA business and also familiar with entrepreneurship. So you're asking a question to the right guy. It's very different because MBA and sports, MBA, it's a, technically it's a monopolistic organization. And people are willing to work there for less wages. And there is lots of like a media exposure and lots of potential like financial reward and some other stuff. It's a very circle, you know, circle friend. So, oftentimes the values that people go to work in these corporate jobs, oftentimes are quite different, or I would say opposite, the values that another entrepreneur offering some, whether it's a startup or small business or, you know, business transition. So it's very extremely different, you know. So people qualities are very different. Most of the cases, I mean, some businesses might be very similar. I don't see much similarities at all. I mean, I go to this entrepreneurship seminar. I'm getting my DBA in entrepreneurship. I always interview successful business people. I mean, probably similarities that both entities are for-profit entities and they try to generate profit. But it's so different that I cannot even, you know, I can talk to about all the probably similarities would be better, but they're very different. You know, so it's, you know, so yeah. That's the best answer for you.
Okay. So this is my resume and cover letter that
sure.
I made. Check them out. But I would like you to ask me some questions. If I was looking to be hired by you, what two questions would you ask me?
Well, apparently when you're coming out of school, you don't have much to offer. Which is good, you know. Well, first ask everybody, you know, and I can ask this question direct, or I can ask this direct. Do you really like, have you had the chance to prepare for today's interview? Have you had a chance to ask all the questions about our entities? And is this really what you'd like to do? You know? And this question is positive, obviously. I would like to engage with you in deep conversation how about your vision, about information needed for you to add value to our entity, right? Because neither my side or our team side, and I'm pretty sure size businesses don't basically this workers or employees that are working just for a paycheck. You know? We want somebody that has mutual values, and we will be investing time with you, right? We would like investing time and resources in you, but we also would like to have that we as a company can deliver your long-term goals. Unfortunately, the people are not very honest about it sometimes. They need a paycheck tomorrow for various reasons. So that's a challenge, you know, that's a challenge how to actually have this connection and how to get the right person. So all these questions, right, all these questions I'll ask you would serve that purpose. You know? So whether it's a why, and then, I mean, I don't know the second question. It's very vague. You know, maybe in corporate world, like, they do that, but in our world, you know, take our time and, you know, we do our homework and we really want people that really want to be with us, you know.
Yeah.
So we don't, I mean, otherwise we don't need them. You know?
And what are some of those values that you like to have within your organization?
I'll tell you good, right? And I'll ask you a question.
Okay.
Oh, this is a question I'm asking people.
Okay.
So if I ask you, which of, I mean, if you, 10 push-ups. You've done push-ups, right? You're a strong guy. So which is the, if I tell you to do 10 push-ups in front of me, and I ask you which one is the most difficult to do? Well, I'll tell you 20 push-ups, because 10 is nothing for you, obviously. I'll do the 20 push-ups. So at which number, you know, you start kind of getting, you know, tightness, and which one is the most difficult to do? You know, like the one that it's really difficult and really have to literally push yourself. You tell me which one, from 1 to 20.
I would say probably about number 18.
Why 18?
18, because that's the point where you got to push through. You're almost past. You're almost to the finish line, which you've worked strenuously up to that point. It's just that last leg. That you really got to push through.
So you're probably going to have a hard time getting a job with us, because if I were sitting in your table, I'll tell 25th. Are you willing to take that extra step? Are you willing to stay another hour in the office? Are you willing to spend your own like a $10 to get a coffee with a potential lead? Are you willing to do something outside of the box to do best for the company? So, I mean, you're young, you can use the technique, right? But I oftentimes ask these people, and they don't want to do that. And we live in a world that is completely understandable and justifiable. But we're looking for these people that are willing to do 21, 22 pushes without us telling them to do so. This is the key of success in a new economy, right? So this is the people we want to find. And it's the people we want to have put our limited resources to, because we know when we sleep and when we don't feel well and when we don't see something, they will do this extra 2, 3, 4, 5 push-ups and they'll get company in the right direction. Okay. Good?
Very good. Very good. Ask me one more question.
Oh, you're 19, right?
Yes.
From all the coming, you're 19 years old. Do you pick up your cell phone? I mean, do you like pick up your cell phone, or you prefer not to pick up your cell phone? If there is a call coming in, are you going to pick up your phone, or is it going to let you go in a voicemail?
Say I'm working on that right now. Typically, if it's a number that I don't know, I wouldn't pick the phone up. But I'm working on answering every call that I get.
Yes.
You never know who's calling.
Exactly. So this is the little details that shows you how credible you are, how dependable you are, right? So, see? I don't know who's calling. Hello? I have medical business, so I have to pick up the phone. But we live in an era that kids like you, they have a... So basically, you probably know this story about boomers and, you know, Nexters and Xters or whatever, right? The biggest problem that you guys have, your generation, it's really hard for focus, you know, focus, because you have so much like electronic options, and you have, you're very spread out. You have Facebook. How many people have on Facebook? Your Facebook page? How many friends?
1,500.
You see? So, 1,500, that's a lot. So the key ingredient, and this is not me, this is the guy who, I forgot his name, Chinese guy, Alibaba CEO, I actually saw him. He said, key ingredient of success is learning how to really be focused on people, right? And really kind of really detailed know.